everybody. Norm here with Tested at Maker Faire Bay Area 2019. I'm in a cage here with Tony. Tony, you guys run a mech warfare league. Tell me about these robots you build and this combat that you do.
So mech warfare is meant to be an urban combat environment where you pilot your robot from a first-person point of view. So there's a little camera at the end of this. And when the pilots are fighting the matches, all they can see is what the robot sees through this camera. And they're simulcast on some monitors that we have over there. But you know, you have target plates, you have four target plates. You start out with 20 points at the beginning of the round. And then whoever has the most points at the end wins. And usually it's like a shootout. These are airsoft rifles. And we just take the automatic electronic gun out of an airsoft rifle and flip it upside down. And then at the bottom, there's like a hopper. And it just pushes the BBs up through this into the gun.
I love that these robots are using a lot of off-the-shelf components as the base platforms. You know, FPV racing gives you your low latency video. These robots are on like a mechanized platform that I assume are pretty standardized, right?
Yeah, these are just Dynamixels. These are the AX12s. A lot of the people have, you know, stronger Dynamixels than this, but in our rookie league, I mean, an AX12 is good enough.
And then, of course, the airsoft comes off of an automatic airsoft. These are the electronic ones, not your gas-powered ones?
Yeah, they're the AEGs. They're the electronic ones, yes.
And then that means that you don't need to actually destroy the robots. It actually is about hitting the target. So explain to me again how the plates work.
So you can only shoot at 200 PSI. That's the maximum. So you're really just shooting at the plates to score points. And so when you hit the plate, a point comes off. There's actually a cooldown period because they wanted to make sure that people are going around and, you know, moving and not just sniping the other player. Some of the guns have a pretty long range. This one can shoot almost all the way across the arena. But in the other league, in the veteran league, there's definitely people that can shoot across the arena. So they wanted to make sure that, you know, you can't just stand there and shoot your opponent. There's a 1 second cooldown if you hit it once. And then if you hit it twice, it's 2 seconds, things like that. So it forces you to move around and shoot multiple target plates to win.
So it is totally less about destruction and more about the creativity of how you design your mech.
Strategy. And my target plates all, you know, stick on the sides. There's definitely some people that have them lower, some people that have them higher. Mm. I've seen people like, you know, make their robot really tall. So then you have to, you know, aim up.
I see a bunch of 3D printed components here. What type of custom fabrication you have to do, and where do the robots vary in terms of their design and aesthetics?
This club design was started by Don Croft. He's here today too. And so the walking gate was developed by Don, but then the actual parts, like a lot of these come from Robotus, and then these AX12s, you order them, and then these black pieces, these are heat synced. So the AX12s probably aren't supposed to, you know, run around the way we do. And so we heat sink them with aluminum so that it pulls the heat away from the servos so your robot doesn't overheat. And then these pieces, this piece right here is cut out. It's laser cut. And then the rest of this is 3D printed. A guy named David Fong on my team, he designed these. And then I just 3D print them as they break. The thing that breaks the most on this robot is the feet. And so I just 3D print more feet and put them on here.
And of course, there's a whole arena here, which is awesome. It's like it's scaled, so the robots live and work as you're watching them from your FPV. It looks massive from that perspective.
Yeah, from the FPV, it looks really cool because it really does feel like you're walking through the city. And a lot of the veterans, I hope I'm not giving away too many spoilers, but like when they come, they really practice walking around the arena so they can get a feel for it. And you'll see some really smooth matches in the Veterans League. People will just run across the arena and look for the other person, and it definitely feels a little bit like Battleship. Some of these buildings, you can shoot between them. Like if you see these little alleyways here, if you're a good shot, you can line up your shot between the buildings. And so that's how I win sometimes, is I hide behind the building and shoot between them.
It's like a video game brought to life. Now you guys are based out of Tucson here in Bay Area. Where can people get involved, find out more if they want to join the Mech Warfare League?
So there's a website. It's called Our Team Robotics. I believe it's ourteamrobotics@weebly.com or ourteamrobotics.weebly.com. That's the website. And there's also a Trossen Electronics Forum, and there's a Mech Warfare blog on there. And you can see what we're going to be doing for Maker Faire if we come again next year and what we do in Tucson. Sometimes in the fall in Tucson, we have a fall mech brawl. And so a lot of us from Tucson, we all fight each other. And sometimes people fly into the Tucson mech brawl and fight us too.
That's so cool. We'll have more information all below. Thank you so much, Tony, and congratulations. I heard you won with your bot Domino.
Yes, so I won the Rookie League, which was a very proud moment for me because a lot of the other guys in the robotics club, you know, they've been fighting for a long time, and I've only been fighting for 3 years, and so it's almost like getting beat up by your big brothers all the time, and then you finally win yourself, so so it's been a fun match.
Thrilling to watch as well. It's a pleasure to meet you, and good luck in the next series.
Thank you.